Just to be upfront and very straightforward, the 6.0 PowerStroke doesn't have a good reputation for reliability. Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on some common Ford 6.0 PowerStroke diesel engine problems. Usually in these videos, I like to circle back to reliability and discuss reliability at the end of the video, but with the 6.0 PowerStroke, there are a couple things that tie into some of the common problems and things that we'll be discussing throughout this video. So figured I'd do this a little bit backwards and jump in, talk about Ford 6.0 PowerStroke reliability, and then all of the actual common problems with the 6.0 diesel engine. Just to be upfront and very straightforward, the 6.0 PowerStroke doesn't have a good reputation for reliability. Some of its poor reputation for reliability is maybe blown out of proportion to some extent. It did have to follow up the legendary 7.3 PowerStroke, which was well known for being a very reliable, long-lasting engine that didn't really have any serious or severe engine problems. And on top of that, the 6.0 PowerStroke came out during a time that was getting a lot stricter on emissions. So it was kind of a tough era for a lot of diesel engines, adding a lot of this emissions equipment, and manufacturers were just having a hard time getting things right and not having issues with a lot of those emission systems, which as we move through this video, you'll see quite a few of the problems are related to various emission systems and things that weren't on previous diesels like the 5.9 Cummins or Ford 7.3 PowerStroke. So ultimately, the 6.0 PowerStroke did have a couple of factors working against it, again, following in the footsteps of the legendary 7.3 PowerStroke, and also just coming out during a tough time for emissions equipment and stricter emissions. I don't want to say that the 6.0 PowerStroke is reliable. However, the 6.0 PowerStroke can actually be made into a very reliable engine. And there's a term that came up and has really grown in popularity in the 6.0 diesel world. And that is the idea of bulletproofing the 6-liter PowerStroke diesel engine. So this term really originated from a company called Bulletproof Diesel, who makes a lot of aftermarket parts and upgrades to improve reliability and address a lot of these common problems on various diesel engines, especially the 6.0 PowerStroke. So that's really how the term originated, but it's really become more of a term now just to imply fixing and upgrading a lot of the problematic areas on the 6.0 PowerStroke to make it reliable. So with some of these modifications and upgrades, the 6.0 PowerStroke can be a very reliable engine. It just takes a little bit of effort, time, and money to actually get the 6-liter diesel to that point. With that said, let's go ahead and jump in and actually discuss the most common problems with the 6.0 PowerStroke. At number one on the list, we have the high pressure oil system. And more specifically, really the high pressure oil pump. So on early 03 and 04 models of the 6-liter diesel, the high pressure oil pump itself was known to be very problematic, along with the IPR and ICP. So a couple things to be on the lookout for those early 03, 04 models. Moving on to 2005 to 2007 6-liter PowerStroke engines, the high pressure oil pump itself and much of the rest of the system was improved and much more reliable. The oil pump itself rarely fails or runs into any issues. However, there was one significant design flaw with the 05 to 07, and that was a snap to connect or STC fitting on the high pressure oil pump. And those STC fittings had pretty close to a 100% failure rate, very problematic, especially in the early days. Ford did update that part and change the design altogether. And that was a good long-term solution and fix for that snap to connect fitting. So most 05 to 07s at this point should have that part fixed and replaced with the newest version that isn't problematic, but a couple old ones could still be floating around out there. So just something to be aware of, but really should be a non-issue in terms of that STC fitting as of now. Moving on to problem number two, we have issues with the 6.0 PowerStroke oil cooler. The oil cooler on the 6.0 PowerStroke is an oil to coolant oil cooler. And so it has both engine coolant and engine oil running throughout the oil cooler. It also uses very small, thin passages, which is great for cooling. However, the flaw with the small, thin passages and channels throughout the oil cooler is that it leaves the oil cooler very prone to clogging and getting stuff gunked up and just blocking those channels and passages over time. A little bit of debris gets in the oil or coolant and it gets stuck in those small channels very easily. So a clogged oil cooler is one way that that fails. Another common cause of failures for the 6.0 oil cooler is the fact that the oil cooler is located in the valley of the engine, so it is subject to some extreme heat. And essentially due to, again, those small, tiny channels on the oil cooler, sometimes those can break, which will actually allow oil and coolant to mix together, which can be a very serious issue if not caught in time. Of course, diluting your oil with the water and coolant mixture reduces its ability to lubricate and protect the engine, so that can lead to very serious engine problems if the oil and coolant are allowed to mix for extended periods and isn't caught soon enough. And lastly, another way that this oil cooler fails is that there is a protective screen to filter the oil moving from the oil cooler into the high pressure oil system and the high pressure oil pump. As these oil coolers age, that protective screen has a tendency to fail, which that screen can then make its way through the high pressure oil pump and damage that oil pump in the process. If the oil pump somehow still continues to run, then that debris and material can make it further downstream into the fuel injectors, which can also take the injectors out with it. So it could be a pretty serious issue if that protective screen fails, as again, that can take out the high pressure oil pump and fuel injectors and potentially other components with it, as that screen and material and debris makes its way downstream and starts damaging other components in the 6.0 PowerStroke. So as we mentioned with bulletproofing, there are some bulletproof upgrades available for the 6.0 PowerStroke oil cooler. Very expensive. Install can also range from about $600 to $1,000, so you could be looking at pretty close to $3,000 all in. Of course, that does protect you against running into any likely issues in the future with the oil cooler. However, comparing that to the OEM oil cooler, which is about $300, it is quite a jump in price. Even if you look at that $300 plus, let's say $700 in labor and install costs, that's $1,000. You would have to fix the oil cooler three times before you really get your money's worth out of the upgraded bulletproof oil cooler. However, it can still be a great upgrade for peace of mind and really just ensuring that you have a reliable 6.0 PowerStroke for the long run. So if you plan on keeping your 6-liter diesel for the long haul, then it might make sense to go ahead and look into upgrades. There also are some slightly cheaper oil cooler upgrade solutions, so there are a couple other things you may consider looking into if it is time to go ahead and replace that oil cooler. Moving on to problem number three with the 6-liter diesel, we have problems with the EGR cooler and EGR valve. So the EGR cooler and EGR valve are both prone to soot buildup and getting clogged over time. When the EGR cooler fails, it will actually allow coolant into the intake manifold, which then makes its way into the cylinders or combustion chambers where it will be burned off. So usually with an EGR cooler problem, you'll usually notice white smoke from the exhaust as well as coolant loss. If the problem's severe enough and enough coolant is dumped into the cylinders, then you could hydrolock your engine, which is obviously a very serious and fatal engine problem. So something to be on the lookout for with those EGR coolers. Now, fortunately, another upside to the earlier model, actually in 2003, the EGR cooler was a round design, which was much less prone to failure than the later 2004 to 2007 square design. That square design is a lot more prone to failing than that 03 model. So if you have one of the later models, the EGR cooler is a little bit more problematic. Nonetheless, the EGR cooler is something that we would certainly recommend upgrading or deleting. The bulletproof EGR cooler is about $300 to $400, I believe. So pretty good price on that diesel EGR upgrade kit. And that will pretty much solve the issues for the long term and make EGR something that you don't have to worry about moving forward. Another popular option is just deleting the EGR altogether. EGR delete kits are, I believe, even a bit under $100, so very cheap, effective solution to eliminate the possibility of EGR problems. However, that is illegal, so something that needs to be factored in before making a decision on what to do with the EGR cooler and EGR valve. on the 6.0 PowerStroke. Moving on to problem number four with the 6.0 PowerStroke is the water pump. So the OEM water pump uses a plastic impeller that's prone to failing, as well as a couple other things that can fail on the 6.0 PowerStroke water pump over time. Usually when the water pump fails, you'll notice a puddle of coolant under the truck. If it happens quickly and severely while you're on the road driving, you'll likely notice low coolant as well as overheating if that coolant level does get low enough. So a couple symptoms to be on the lookout for that could point to the water pump being the issue. The Bulletproof diesel water pump upgrade is $400, so a great value if you do run into a water pump failure and want a long-term bulletproof solution. Then go ahead and look into that water pump. It does use an aluminum impeller and also has upgraded bearing assembly, an upgraded seal, and upgraded housing. So pretty complete upgrade for the water pump. That's a great long-term solution for the 6-liter diesel. Moving on to common problem number five, we have issues with the FICM, or fuel injection control module. This module is responsible for controlling the fuel injectors. A faulty FICM will cause either hard start or no start symptoms. If you are able to get the truck started and the 6.0 PowerStroke does fire up, then you'll likely notice a rough idle, stuttering, hesitation, as well as power loss. So a few symptoms there to be on the lookout for that could point to a faulty fuel injector control module. The failure with this part usually boils down to the power supply in FICM. Bulletproof diesel does have a bulletproof upgrade for this. However, the complete FICM kit, I believe, is about $1,100 to $1,200, so very expensive. If you do run into that issue and you want the bulletproof option, then it's a little bit pricey. That's, again, for the complete kit. If you just want the power supply, then I believe even the upgrade for that is about $600 to $800, so pretty expensive even if you just do the power supply. The alternate option is remanufactured power supplies, usually only run for about $150. So that's going to be the cheapest solution if you do run into problems with the FICM. Moving on to issue number six with the 6.0 PowerStroke, we have fuel injectors. One thing to point out with the fuel injectors is a number of these failures do boil down to other underlying problems. As we discussed with common problem number two, the 6.0 PowerStroke oil cooler. If that protective screen in the oil cooler fails, it can make its way through the high pressure oil pump and into the injectors and take those out in the process. So sometimes some of the commonality with fuel injectors failing on the 6.0 PowerStroke can be blamed on other underlying issues that then take out the fuel injectors in the process. However, the 6.0 PowerStroke injectors are also prone to sticking, so that is a problem to look out for and consider with the 6.0 PowerStroke, but ultimately, fuel injectors are at least one of the less common problems that we're discussing on this list, but just still something to be aware of and consider, especially if you run into a stuck injector. Last but not least, on the list here at number seven, we have turbocharger problems on the 6-liter PowerStroke diesel. This isn't extremely common, but turbos do take a lot of abuse and wear and tear over the years. At this point, the 6.0 PowerStroke is 15 plus years old, and so sometimes those turbos can just fail due to wear and tear, standard age and mileage on the vehicle and on the turbocharger. So there are those turbo failures and turbo problems to consider. However, another thing is the VGT turbo on the 6.0 PowerStroke and the VGT vanes are prone to soot buildup. So that can start causing turbo issues. Fortunately, the solution there is usually just pulling the turbo, cleaning it all up, getting everything looking new again, get all that soot out of there, and that will usually solve the problems. But again, there's still some failures that just boil down to normal wear and tear and age and mileage on the 6.0 PowerStroke diesel nowadays. With that said, that wraps up our video for today, guys. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, guys.